Hello everyone, today I am continuing my previous session which I have taken on NLP, Natural Language Processing. So today's topic, Human Language versus Computer Language. In the previous video, I have explained the different applications of NLP, definition of NLP, what are the different parts of NLP, objective, aim, etc. and the types of chatbot. The differences. Now I am taking the session on human language versus computer language. Why this is required to know? Because if you are trying to make an application to understand, to enable computer to understand human language, then you have to first understand the differences and similarities between these two. If we are talking about human language, then we can understand that humans communicate through language, which we process all the time. Even when we are sleeping, then in dream we can communicate. We are thinking about different things, and in our thought process we are again communicating through language. Our brain keeps on processing the sounds that it hears around itself and tries to make sense out of them all the time. Even we are listening chirping sound, whistle, beep sound, and see, clock. So whatever we are listening, we are hearing, we are processing that sound. Even in the classroom, as the teacher delivers the session, our brain is continuously processing everything and is storing it in some place. Also, while this is happening, when your friend whispers something, the focus of your brain automatically shifts from the teacher's speech to your friend's conversation. Is it happening? Yes. So now the brain is processing both the sounds, but is prioritizing the one on which our interest lies. दोनों हम सुन रहे हैं, टीचर की वॉइस भी सुनाई देगी, फ्रेंड की भी सुनाई देगी. अब ये प्रायोरिटी हम डिसाइड करेंगे कि कब किसकी बात सुननी है. सो प्रायोरिटाइजिंग द वन ऑन विच अवर इंटरेस्ट लाइज. नाउ द ह्यूमन लैंग्वेज, हाउ इट वर्क्स विद अवर बॉडी. द साउंड रीचेस द ब्रेन थ्रू अ लॉन्ग चैनल. एज अ पर्सन स्पीक्स, द साउंड ट्रेवल्स फ्रॉम हिज माउथ and goes to the listener's eardrum. The sound striking the eardrum is converted to neuron impulse in this way, and these impulse gets transported to the brain and then gets processed. After processing the signal, the brain gains understanding around the meaning. After processing the signal, brain gains meaning of it, and if it is clear, meaning is clear, then signal gets stored in the brain, and if it is not clear, listener asks for clarity to the speaker. On the other hand, the computer language. Computer understand the language of numbers. Everything that is sent to the machine has to be converted to numbers, means in machine language. And while typing, if a single mistake is made, the computer throws an error and does not process that part. The communication made by machines are very basic and simple, not complicated like human language. Now, enabling machines to understand human language. Now, if we want the machine to understand our language, what should this happen? How should this happen? What are the possible difficulties a machine would face in processing natural language? Let us take a look. अब आपने मशीन को इनेबल करना है हमारी लैंग्वेज समझने के लिए, ह्यूमन लैंग्वेज समझने के लिए. सो दीज आर द डिफिकल्टीज विच ए मशीन कैन फेस. अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द वर्ड्स एंड मीनिंग, मीन्स द ग्रामर, द सिंटैक्स दैट मशीन नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड. सेकेंड, मल्टीपल मीनिंग्स ऑफ अ वर्ड. वेन वी आर यूजिंग अ वर्ड इन डिफरेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट, इट कैन गिव डिफरेंट मीनिंग. सो वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड the meaning of words in different context. And the third is perfect syntax, no meaning. Yes, it also happen when we are writing the perfect grammatically correct statement, but the statement is creating no sense. So what we need to do? First, need to understand these challenges, these difficulties. The number one, arrangement of the words and meaning. We know there are rules in human language. There are nouns, verbs, adverb, adjective. And a word can be a noun at one time and an adjective some other time. Let's see the example. There are three examples given. The first is a cricket bat. Here cricket is, as we know, it is noun, name of the insect and the name of a game. But here a cricket bat is, in this phrase, cricket is an adjective. And in second phrase, a car race. As we know, car is noun. But here car is used as an adjective. So the arrangement of the word and meaning is important to understand. The rules, syntax, grammar of human language gives structure to human language. Why this is important? Grammar ko itna hum kyun emphasize karte hain? Because it gives a structure to human language. Like noun, verb, adjective, adverb, etc. All these things and their arrangement make sense in this structure of human language. Now, how computer do this? This is just an example of POS tagging. One way of computer understanding how it do. To interpret human language, computer needs to understand them. And example, computer uses POS tagging. POS means parts of speech tagging to identify the different parts of speech. Now, here I have shown an example of syntactic diagram, tree diagram of statement of a sentence, which we are practicing in English to understand parts of speech. I am showing you an online activity to understand, clarify the POS tagging a little bit more. Okay, I am taking an activity beginner level. So here a sentence is written, Romeo was young. This is a sentence. So if we are, we need to make a syntactic tree diagram, then first we have to start this sentence with root. So this is a sentence, so root is sentence and the tag is S. Now I have put it a tag S. Now as we know that sentence has two part, subject part and predicate part. This subject part is having noun, so it is known as verb phrase, sorry, noun phrase. So this is the tagging for noun phrase NP. Now in this noun phrase, Romeo single word is there, it is a noun. So I am putting N here, this is for noun and Romeo will be linked with this branch. Now the predicate part here, I will in the tab, sorry, the tag verb phrase is used for this part. And in this verb phrase VP, we have to put two more tags for this verb was. We cannot directly put verb. We have to put first verb phrase. Then for young, we are putting young adjective phrase. Young is adjective, so we have to put adjective phrase here. Now for verb phrase, we are putting now verb, direct verb we cannot put here. So first we have to put a tag verb, then the verb was. And in this adjective phrase, as written, boy, young is an adjective, so I have to put an adjective tag here. Where is this? And then the word young. Now check this tree. Yes, it is correct. So this tagging is written here in the form of statements. So this is correct. This way we can make syntactic tree diagram to understand the parts of speech in English statements. Similarly, computer is also using parts of speech tagging to identify different parts of a speech. This is an example of Python coding. When we are writing any program and we need to use POS tagging to understand human language, we can use NLTK library and we can write codes this way for POS tagging. No need to go in detail. I have just shown you example so that you can understand how it works in AI coding. Meaning behind the language we use. This is another difficulty which a machine can face. Besides the matter of arrangement, there's also meaning behind the language we use. Human communication is complex. Means if you are speaking something in front of a child, it can create different meaning. But if you will speak the same statement in front of an old lady, it can give different sense. and in front of a lady, it can give different meaning. So there are multiple characteristics of the human language that might be easy for a human to understand but extremely difficult for a computer to understand. An analogy with programming language means, suppose you are using the same word in different languages, different programming language, or different version of the programming language, it can give different meaning. So this is another challenge. I am giving you an example of it. See, there 2 plus 3, this statement is written in two different way, means two different syntax. One is 2 plus 3, another was 3 plus 2. So different syntax are here used, but it will give the same result. 5 means different syntax but same semantics, means same meaning. And another example here, same syntax, I have written the same statement 2/3, 2 upon 3 in two different programming languages, means two different versions of Python programming language, in Python 2.7 and in Python 3. I have written the same syntax, but it will create different meanings, so different semantics. In Python 2.7, 2/3 will give result 1, and in Python 3, it will give the result 1.5, a real number. So this is the analogy with programming language. Now another difficulty, multiple meaning of a word. Here I am taking the same example given in your book. Three statements are given which are using the same word red and giving the different meaning of red in all these statements. Let's take have a look. This is the first statement. His face turned red after he found out that he took the wrong bag. What does this mean? Is he feeling ashamed because he took another person's bag instead of his? Galti se kisi aur ka bag utha liya, ab sharam aa rahi hai. So it may be, ye meaning bhi nikal sakta hai. And is he feeling angry because he did not manage to steal the bag that he has been targeting? Yes, it may also happen. Dono hi meaning isse nikalte hain. But what is the context, we don't know. So this statement can have both the meaning. Now another example, the red car zoomed past his nose. Very simple, the here red car means red colored car, probably talking about the color of the cars. Here the meaning of the red is different. Another sentence, his face turns red after consuming the medicine. It may also have two meaning. Is he having an allergic reaction? Means maybe after taking the medicine, because of some allergic reaction, the face turns red. So this is another meaning. The same sentence can have another meaning, that is he not able to bear the taste of that medicine? That's why his face turns red. So the red word is used in these three sentences but giving different meaning in different context. In all three sentences, the word red has been used in three different ways, which according to the context of the statement changes its meaning completely. Thus, in natural language, it is important to understand that a word can have multiple meanings and the meanings fit into the statement according to the context of it. Third difficulty, perfect syntax, no meaning. Sab kuch sahi likha tha, grammar sahi thi, words sahi the, spelling sahi tha, par meaning nahi nikla. Sometimes a statement can have a perfectly correct syntax, correct grammar, but it does not mean anything. Means the statement will not give any sense. What to do? Take an example. Chickens feed extravagantly while the moon drinks tea. The statement is grammatically perfectly correct, but make any sense? No. So this is the problem. Thus, it is important to understand in human language, a perfect balance of syntax and semantics is important for better understanding. Both should be perfectly balanced. Now, natural language processing do this magic. How? These are some of the challenges we might have to face if we try to teach computers how to understand and interact in human language. So, how does natural language processing do this magic? For this, we need to understand data processing. I will take this session in my another video. Till then, bye-bye.